Good morning, students. Today we will learn learning. We will discuss definition, characteristics, principles today. Okay. Definition. According to Hunter and Hilgard, learning is the process by which an organism is satisfying its motivation, adopts and adjusts its behavior in order to overcome obstacles and barriers. According to Hedkerken, learning is not an addition of experience, nor is old experience summed up. Rather, it is the synthesis of old and the new experiences which result in completely new organization or pattern of experience. Definition. According to Woodsworth R.H., an activity can be called learning so far as it develops the individual and makes its behavior and experiences different from what that would otherwise have been. According to Schunk, learning is an enduring change in behavior or in the capacity to behave in a given fashion which results from practice or other forms of experience. Characteristics. Number one, learning is adjustment, learning is purposeful, learning is experience, learning is growth, learning is intelligent, learning is active, learning is both individual and social, learning is the product of the environment, learning affects the conduct of the teacher and students. Learning helps in making choice. Learning helps to bring changes. Learning helps in continuous professional development. Learning helps keep in tune in with trends and development in particular fields. Then we will see what are the principles in learning. For effective learning, teacher guidance, self-discovery, generalization of past experience, background experience, sufficient mental maturity, readiness and desire of learner, goal-directed provisional trials, new has meaning related to old, motivation of learner, provision for transfer, no anxiety and mental illness. An essential influence of environment through practice, feedback and evaluation. Then what are the domains of learning? We will discuss cognitive, psychomotor and affective. Number one, cognitive. Number two, psychomotor. Number three, affective. In cognitive domain, what are the levels of cognitive domain? Number one, knowledge. Number two, comprehension. Number three, application. Number four, analysis. Number five, synthesis. Number last, evaluation. Then we will discuss affective domain. What are the levels of affective domain? Number one, receiving. Number two, responding. Number three, valuing. Number four, organization. Number five, characterization. Last one, receiving. Okay. Then last one, psychodomain. What are the levels of psychodomain? Number one, perceiving. Number two, patternings, otherwise setup. Next one, accommodating. Next one, refining. Next one, verifying. Next one, improvising. Last one, composing, origination. Okay. Now we will learn factors affecting learning. It divides into two. Number one, internal factors. Number two, external factors. Internal factors are age, intelligence, attention, interest, holistic, health, maturation, observation, and learning, fatigue, insight. Then external factors are knowledge, meaningfulness, exercise and repetition, by parts learning, teaching and learning, environment, learning situation, motivation and learning, clarity, task orientation, student involvement, variety, teacher enthusiasm. What are the theories of learning? We will discuss about theories here. Number one, conditioning theory. Number two, learning by trial and error. Number three, learning by observation and imitation. Number four, learning by doing. Next one, learning by remembering. Next one, learning by insight. Next one, learning is measured by performance of activities. Next one, sensory stimulation theory. Another one, behaviorist learning theory. Operant conditioning. Drive reduction theory. Cognitive gestalt theory, facilitation theory. Then sensory stimulation theory. It is learning through the senses like smell, sight, hearing, taste, and touch. Behaviorist learning theory. All species of animals learn in similar. To understand learning processes, focus on stimulus and responses. Internal process should be excluded from the study of learning. Learning is evidenced by behavioral change. Organisms are blank slates at birth. Learning is a result of environmental events. In operant conditioning, we will discuss about this. Learning where frequency of behavior depends on the consequences that follows the behavior. The frequency of behavior will increase if the consequence is reinforcing to the subject. The frequency of behavior will decrease if the consequence is not reinforcing or punishing to the subject. Operant conditioning divided by two. Number one, reinforcement. Number two, punishment. In reinforcement, any consequences that increases the likelihood of the behavior it follows. In punishment, any consequences that decreases the likelihood of the behavior it follows. In reinforcement, positive and negative reinforcement. In positive reinforcement, anything that increases the likelihood of a behavior by following it. Now we will learn cognitive gestalt theory. In this, importance is on experience, meaning, problem solving and development of insights. Concept is individuals have different needs and concerns at different times and that they have subjective interpretations in different contexts. Then, key to learning and changing is individuals' cognitions like perception, thought, memory, and ways to processing and structuring information. See next one, facilitation theory. The humanistic approach. In this, developer Carl Roger, learning will occur by the educator acting as a facilitator. An atmosphere comfortable, not threatened by the external factors. Then, learning by trial and error. It will be slow, laborious, primitive type. Example, child will learn by imitation and trial and error method. Next one, learning by observation and imitation. Observation promotes attention, discrimination and recognition. Skills are learned by observation method only. Example, during demonstration. We will learn more in demonstration. Next, learning by doing. For example, nursing procedures. Next one, learning by remembering. For example, memorizing events and dates. Next one, learning by insight. For example, problem solving. Next one, learning is measured by performance of activities, teachers, observation of students' performance in theory and learning. Next, we will discuss about relationship between teaching and learning. Number one, both teaching and learning may be formal or informal. Number two, both are goal-oriented. Number three, good teaching results in good learning. Next one, one can observe teaching but not learning. Next one, both teaching and learning require skills, creativity and intelligence and operate on definite principles. Next one, good teaching requires good communication skill and good learning requires good listening skills. Last one, only good learners become good teachers. Okay, after all, we need communication skill and learning skills, included listening skills. Okay.